Since we're doing an episode on art and design, there is no better place to start than right here at the SF Art Exchange. And joining me as always, my co-host, Crystal Lee.
Hey, I'm over here.
Oh, hey.
What's up?
How's it going?
So check this place out.
It's awesome.
You know, this place houses the works of art of over 200 of the most legendary artists, photographers, musicians, you name it.
You know, I want to learn a little bit more about this place. Can you help me out with that?
Absolutely. Check this out.
Today I have the pleasure of sitting here at the San Francisco Art Exchange with Theron, who's one of the owners and founders. First of all, thanks for sitting down with me. It's really great to be here. Your space is phenomenal. The only way I can describe it at this moment is moving. You have to come and see these works of art and these photographs. You're the top Beatles photography dealer in the world. Well, how does that come to be, and what does that mean exactly?
And what that means is we've sold more fine art photographs of the Beatles signed by the photographers than anybody else in the world. All the major shots, the major sessions, fly on the wall shots, iconic images. But the thing that is exciting to have for us are the shots nobody's seen.
Obviously, every piece makes you feel something. And when I saw the Jimi Hendrix piece on the wall, it just hit me right in the feels, because Hendrix is amazing. And you have it in black and white, and you also have like a different version of it with color. How did that come to be?
Yeah, the photographer's name, Garrett Mankiewicz. The shot you're talking about was shot in black and white, but because Jimmy was a very colorful personality, how he looked on stage, he was decorating himself while he was performing. So the black and white structure inspired Garrett to add color to it that was sort of befitting such a colorful character.
In every piece, you're sort of taken back in time to like a different place. So you look at the piece with the Rolling Stones all on the ground with their feet in the center in the circle. What is the story behind it?
Well, that photograph of the Stones was taken by Ethan Russell. When Ethan suggested this composition, they were ready to jump in and did it.
I definitely want to go take a tour of the gallery. Can we do that?
It'd be a pleasure.
This is what we were talking about earlier, that Stones photo. It's very cool.
I had a chance to talk to Theron before, and now I'm with the co-owner, Jim. We're up on the mezzanine. Tell me, how did you guys meet, and how did this all get started?
I ended up working with a gallery, a major gallery in San Francisco, and there was this other fellow named Theron. We decided we wanted to go and try it our way rather than somebody else's way. And we started the San Francisco Art Exchange, 1983.
So you would say basically then that you guys started the rock and roll art, I don't wanna say scene, but I mean, maybe the market for it, that's what you guys did.
We saw it as an art form, and that was the secret.
Where do you see things going in the future? Where's the gallery going to?
We've been asked recently to represent two really major collections that we've been involved with. One of which is the original design drawings for 2001 Space Odyssey.
Oh, wow.
So this sort of thing that we see coming more and more often and in larger and larger in scale.
Amazing. This is a place you have to come and check out. There's just no other way for you to get the feeling of what's going on here without being here yourself.